Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari at the Castle of Many Eye, the entrance, which has closed around us. So, really don't have much recourse at this point. But we have plenty of potions, herbs. We have, for the most part, these round of magic. I wonder if we should. Should we just sleep already? I don't know. No, I think we'll wait. We went through quite a lot of expense just coming here. Forward, I guess? I don't know. So many choices as far as where to go. I prefer not to be surprised by things. Second to last dungeon in the game, no surprise it's gonna be rather a big one. Just testing for secret walls and stuff. Okay, we got a door. Oh! And we got a monster. Are you a troll? Oh yeah, like a bunch of cave trolls, actually, yeah. Ice bitter, or whatever. Got a bunch of ice balls. I'm gonna let them come to us. So for now, we'll use ice balls on these guys. Our protections, I believe I saw, were all up, so just fight. That was a single character. Yeah, it should be all complete character. I'm gonna wait though. Should I cast Storm? Storm, which monster? Yeah, I'll cast Storm on that guy. And we have a Holy Sword, which is good against undead. So he really doesn't have much he can do. So Gribban will just hang out. Silk is out of arrows, unfortunately. He's just gonna hang out. And these guys are okay. So Amethyst will just hang out. We got a few attacks in on this guy, and we'll see where these guys. These two probably gonna move over, and these two move up. It did hit two in that row, okay. Storm on that one. So Teen missing and doing that damage. Skull Hunters! So these are Skull Hunters. They are hunting our skulls. So we're going to focus on this one now, keeping in mind the one all the way to the right is somewhat damaged, so we'll go for him next. Tornado is so... yeah. Can only use that three times, so I'm going to cast Ice Ball. I don't know how tough these things are, but we're going to find out. I'll have Silk start moving over. Hitting for a good amount of damage. I suspect we'll take this one out. Would that one resist? Hitting for 20. Jobineer 20, 21. Gaban hit for 16. 8. They each attack twice. Got it. Well, they're still standing, these things. Okay. I'm just gonna keep throwing ice balls here. Once this was is engaged, I mean, being attacked by somebody, I'll have Silk come over here and hit him with the Assassin's Blade. I, however, will heal somebody. I like Gaban. Yeah. Curious to see how much it takes to take one down. Good. It took that much. You hit pretty hard. So I think Gaban has the better armor, that's why when he gets hit, I don't know if it's affecting his chance to get hit, but when he does get hit, it's for less. Does he? Yeah, armor of endurance. His shield 15, but then it ups his constitution, which I think would affect his hit points. Shield 15, but... And plus he has a shield. He also has the tower shield. Which Jobineer just has regular late mail. I don't know why I keep going that. Which is shield 15 also. He just doesn't have the, what do you call it? Through our items really quickly. I don't know if we'll ever have a use for these empty flasks, but they are there in case we do. Okay. Jobineer. I have some of us focus on taking this one out. It was already affected by a couple ice balls and a storm. How about, actually, I wonder if he could tank for Silk. Next round I'll bring Silk up with the Assassin's Blade, maybe that'll do something. Or be effective, whatever. Damage at all. Ditto. I love to see that. 4 points. Ah, yeah, no problem at all this round. Still gonna heal him again. so I can move out. Gonna have to rest after this encounter. Just to get tragic mana back and nothing else. Okay. If we're done with these guys. Negligible damage. And no damage. These guys aren't doing as much damage as they were in the beginning. Throw some rocks. Good enough. Soak doing some damage. Wow. We thrashed that thing at the end. Sweet. 83 experience for everyone. Wow. 500 gold and 32 rations. Wow. Skull Hunter meat. Okay, we've got a force field. So mapping that out. Should we go hide by the door? Assuming these things don't open doors. I bet you no one can handle this much. 57. So, resting. So he's full. He's good. Yeah, but no one can heal this amount of rations. Unless I start moving gold around too, and I don't feel like doing that. We'll be okay. We're wasting rations, but we have a lot of them, so it's alright. So I really want to check the map when we're all done with this. We're seeing how this, at least this first floor, is really huge. She has a lot of rations too. We all do. Oh. Didn't mean to do that. Thank you. He's not quite there. Another three, yeah, might as well. That's not really cost effective with the rations, but... So, as far as this, I'm wondering if I should save this for some overland traveling. The Wand of Light, we only have 14 more charges. We could have Satine cast Light 2, which uses up her mana and lasts for less time, but we don't use up the charges on that. Because he's out of torches, I decided to stop carrying torches, at least for the time being. Because they take up weight and stuff, so... Yes, I'll have her cast Light along with her other spells. Arm Protection 2. It's Power 3. Into Magic 3. And Light 2. Boom. Take a look at Zimap. Yeah, it looks quite big. So I don't know what's going to teleport there. We're going to visit that at a later date. Be surprised at all if we find more of them. This really just goes on and on. Just mapping it out. So some, like, central teleport chamber. Alright, maybe we'll go back and check this out. Dead end. Another door. Have we been here? Yeah, this is where we were. Alright. Boo! Garbage, or perhaps a hidden treasure? No. Just random garbage, landmark or something. Really? So then this central chamber with garbage is in it instead. Ah, I don't know. Streaks on the floor. I'm glad we have a map, because otherwise I'd be completely lost. dead end. Got more garbage? Oops. Oh wait, something. Oh, what'd it say? Wait a second. Here lie several helmets, hats, and shields. A buckler, a tower shield, a round shield, a buckler, small tower shield, a gold helmet. That looks like a good thing to have. A small tower shield, a hat, a metal helmet, horn helmet, round shield, and a shield of parry. Now what did I do? Did I sell my shield of parry? I might have. Well, I definitely want to take a look at this gold helmet. Now I can't even get to the end, which is annoying. Because that means... Okay, we did map it. Alright. So Jobinir actually can use this Necklace of Wisdom. Okay, so Shield of 8, Warrior or Paladin can use it. I don't have a Ranger or not. Shield of 8. Magic resistance 15 and has 10 charges of reincarnation. Hello. Paladin and warrior. What do our paladin and warrior have now? Shield of 6. Which is the same, I imagine. Oh wait. This is... Shield of 6. Okay, so I am going to give this to Jobinir so you can cast Reincarnate. So now I have that in my spell selection. Griban has the staff, and Jobinir has it. So we'll be like really diversified with our helmets. And I could just drop this. I don't think it even sells for that much. Could be wrong, but we have enough money. Yeah. I'm gonna go out of that. So, transfer gold helmet. Boom. So now his shield is 36 versus Griban 42. What else we got? That's the same metal helmet. The horn helmet isn't as much. The hat, I mean, unless these things are magical. No one could care. Tower shield. So I'm gonna throw it away so he can pick up another one. And then identify it. See if it has any magical properties. This is a regular tower shield. Should I try it on the other one? Because I think there is another one. Oh, there's the shield of parry. Round shield. I can't identify stuff unless we're holding it, right? It needs to be held by somebody. It needs to be held. I'm just gonna... I mean, there might be magical stuff here. I don't feel like... I mean, I have a lot of charges on this thing, but I don't feel like seeing if, each item is magical. I'm willing to bet only the gold helmet is magical, because we've never seen anything like that. But we know at least one item is not magical, so... I'm willing to bet the rest aren't either. There's no, like, gold or anything, right? No. So I wonder... who piled up these shields? Someone defeated some adventurers and just dumped their equipment here. Ooh! A lot of different items are to be found in this recess. Ooh! Boots of Mora? Mora? Well, it could be a cursed thing. Can we pick up, like, a Cloak of Mora or something? Grams. Okay, doesn't help with anything. Cursed. 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 Speed minus 30. And we can't even drop it, right? Even though we're not wearing it? But we can. As long as we don't put it on. Makes sense. Alright, what else we have? A bunch of things. A big... healing potion, the small healing potion, another big healing potion, two poison, I believe, and yeah, poison, and then this thing, blindness. All right, we'll take all the ones we can and see if Jobinir can hold the torches. Kind of stack them if possible. Sometimes it kicks you out of transfer mode, and you have to click the icon again. Alright, we were able to take all of it. Sweet, so little treasure nooks. I approve. Oh, something else. This heap consists of a large number of weapons. Trident, dagger. Dagger of Might. A longsword, a morning star, a sling, a knife, a mace, a knife, a club, a sling, and a flail. Flails are good money to sell, but I don't know if we can carry it. But this dagger of might, definitely interested in that. That's not a person, it's between two people. It's a way we're not finding rocks and ammo. Maybe we will. The trident is very expensive to buy. It's not that great, right? Damage 15. I want to look at this. I want to look at it. Assassin's Blade, spelled wrong. Damage 18. This gives a bonus to attack and speed and to X-ray vision power. But this is 25. This is 24. So if our light runs out, we'll start using torches again. If, you know, when. Also, it's a dagger of might. Satine ended up taking it. Ten damage. Gives also shield of two. Intelligence. 10. Read magic scroll, bonus of 25, and 15 uses of hailstorm. Hailstorm is freaking awesome. Yeah? Mm. Well, I have a staff of might. I forgot I was even holding this. X-ray vision. Use magic 10. Maybe I should carry this dagger instead. I'm carrying too many things. We're probably going to have to start dropping gold soon. Look at all this freaking gold we have. And we just recently turned it all into gems. We had, like, hardly anything left. But fortunately now we have nothing to spend the gold on, really. Not that much, as far as I know, unless something else pops up. So I want to give this to somebody, anybody. Yeah, I'm just gonna dump it all. Sad to say. Now, he still has a slot. Take that, thank you. Cool. Where was I anyway? This helps with you read magic scroll. Could be helpful because one of us isn't all the way up on that. Read magic scroll 25, intelligence of 10, and 15 hailstorms? Bear with me, I have 15 hailstorms. My read magic scroll is 69. My intelligence is 57. 94 to 95, sweet. With my intelligence now above human limits. I love it. So is there anything else we want? I don't think so, actually. Should I see if this is a magical longsword? How can we pass that up, right? No. Regular longsword. Are there more things? There are. This heap consists of a lot of old armor.